I took refuge until my demands reached. By the merit of practicing generosity and other good deeds, may I attain Buddhahood for the sake of all sentient beings. In the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha most excellent, I take refuge until enlightenment is reached. By the merit of practicing generosity and other good deeds, may I attain Buddhahood for the sake of all sentient beings. In the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha most excellent, I take refuge until enlightenment is reached. By the merit of practicing generosity and other good deeds, may I attain Buddhahood for the sake of all sentient beings. May all mother sentient beings boundless the sky have happiness and causes of happiness. May they be liberated from suffering and causes of suffering. May they never be separated from the happiness that's free from suffering. May they rest in equanimity, free from attachment and aversion. May all mother sentient beings boundless the sky have happiness and the causes of happiness. May they be liberated from suffering and the causes of suffering. May they never be separated from the happiness that's free from suffering. May they rest in equanimity, free from attachment and aversion. May all mother sentient beings boundless the sky have happiness and the causes of happiness. May they be liberated from suffering and the causes of suffering. May never be separated from the happiness that's free from suffering. May they rest in equanimity, free from attachment and aversion. Thank you. So please just relax, you know, and then we'll go through those explanation. So here, as you see from this yesterday, from this morning, how the mindfulness is important, as well as awareness, introspection, introspection, how they are very important. With this, they are the key point which helps us to train ourselves, our mind, so that our mind becomes helpful for our peace and happiness. You know? So this yesterday, today, with different examples, with a different way of expressing how to, you know, train ourselves, how to train our mind itself, you know. This is one of the very important, I mentioned a few times, the greatest things, you know, the mind is the greatest thing that we have, you know. There's no greater than that mind that we have. Actually, the mind is the, as explained, if it is in the wrong place, it's the worst enemy we have. And if the mind is in the right place, the best friend we have. So please see this and understand this, acknowledge. And because of this, then we always be mindful, you know, to just place our mind in the virtuous state. No? So he has said now here, page 64, verse 21. Yes, you see. If this is how I act and live, now it's explained before, all those examples, you know, if I live my mind, my life, you know, accordingly, what's explained. And I act accordingly with that. And so then, even in the midst of evil folks, no matter how the aggressive people come, you know, we have a such kind of mental vision how to handle that. We have prepared well to whether we can change that person or not, but at least we will not disturb our mind. That's the most important, you know. That, or even with a fair woman. So this is, Shantideva was talking to the monks, you know. So now here you can say with a fair man for the woman, you know. Yeah. See, it's called alternate, you know. So that you will not involve with problems, you know. See, you know. All is well. So with this, you know, all are like this, you see. This is very important to how to maintain our mind in the right place. That's what I mean, you know. My steady keeping of the vows will not decline, see. When you have this, then we have like say, for the lay people, like say, five precepts and so on. You know? We can keep those precepts without any problem. You know? We can live our life. So as you see, Buddha made these different types of precepts, vows, not to control us. Some people think, oh, I cannot keep those precepts. These are very difficult, you know. It's like a feeling of like controlling, you know. Like Buddha is controlling us, you know. Actually, Buddha made a kind of like a guideline. This is good for you. If you do this, you are well protected yourself. You are not in danger. Or problems, you see. We don't understand that. Oh, I better not take any vows because I want to have a freedom, you know. And then that freedom becomes miserable, you know. And then throw us in the hell realm, you know. So Buddha, you see, protecting us from this hell realm, going to a hell realm, going to a hungry ghost, you know. So if you keep this, if you do this, 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 you are better off. You know, your life is much safe, and you are in a place of peace, happiness, even in the samsara. And this is the guideline will help you how to free from samsara. So please make that understanding. Otherwise, it's as mentioned, if you don't know, some Buddhism, Buddhist religion, you know, it becomes. When we know carefully, it, and with the understanding, they are not a kind of a rule made by to control. There are some they do to control people, make the rule, you know. No any reason. So you have to do this. Don't ask question. This is the way to be done, you know. So in the Buddha's way, what is this? Out of wisdom, out of compassion. Then this is good. You know, look at this. Like as I mentioned yesterday, like 10 virtues, 10 non-virtues. Look at those. It's not to control people, but to protect from suffering, from the confusion as well. So step by step, so you take refuge in Buddha Dhamma Sangha. It's not you are making, Buddha is not making you to Buddhist, but how to protect, you know, yourself. So once you take refuge in Buddha Dhamma Sangha, do these things, you know, simple things. Then, after that, maybe you can take the five precepts. So, this much you can do so that your life is more peaceful, more harmony, you know. So, then after that, maybe you take 10 precepts, so forth. At the end of the day, to become Buddha, we have to purify all the obscurations. Make sense? We have to develop all the excellent qualities. There's no exception. No? But Buddha is so careful and so wise, so kind. know, giving us some kind of opportunity, step by step. Maybe keep one vow, sometimes Buddha said. Or you just think, I will try to keep one vow sometimes in the future, you know. There's the descriptions in the Gongji, we have that, you know. So that way, we make connection to Buddha. And then we grow slowly, slowly, slowly. No? It may take eons and eons, but eventually, then there's maybe we're free from samsara. No? So this is how, see. So my studies, keeping of the vows will not decline. So that's what the mindfulness, what understanding, protecting your mind. We need a lot of time, energy, you see. Certainly, you cannot control your mind. If you try to control your mind, suddenly you become crazy, you know? So need a skill, step by step, yeah.
早上讲的不就有强调正知正念的重要，怎么样时常有正知正念觉照自己的心念，所以在我们说要修心呢，时常要保持正知正念，然后才能够真正得到真正的快乐。然后早上的前一天也有讲到很多方法，怎么样子来去修心，然后最重要重点呢，还是强调说，没有哪一样东西，没有哪一样法，比注重在修持我的这个修心呢最重要。就是说，修心呢，明白这个心，如果你明白的话，这个是最大最大的宝。如果你不了解这一点呢，不去关照那个心念呢，走错了方向的话，当然得到恶果。如果你能够把那个心放在正知正念呢，和发菩提心呢，得到的果呢，就是快乐。这个就是一种很有效的修行。所以时常呢，都要保持正知正念，把自己的心念带到一种真正那个宁静和没有妄念的境界。然后在这个64页刚才那个红色这个法本里面呢，有讲到就是第21颂里面有讲到就是说行若如是住，虽处恶人中，仰获众女堆，勤戒坚不退。所以就是如果你了悟以上所说的，时常都保温，使你的心清净，使你时常都在处于菩提心的境界，或者就是正知正见呢，虽然你身处于那个五浊恶世有很多坏人的地方呢，别人就算那些人呢要来伤害你或者欺骗你，你都能够因为保持这种心念呢，能够面对它，解决当前的问题。所以呢，最重要的就是我们要护持心的正念，正念。像如果你护持心的正念能够得到的话，这个就是守到真正的戒。佛陀有讲到很多戒，五戒、沙弥尼戒、菩萨戒、比丘戒等等。这些戒律呢，佛陀讲出来，并不是要控制我们， 有很多人呢不明白，就以为佛教佛陀讲这个戒是说这样东西我们不可以做，哪一样不可以做，其实不是这样子的情形。佛陀讲的就是那些戒律其实是帮忙我们，使到我们的心能够修得更好，使到我们不会走错路去做恶事，然后得到恶果。所以呢，这个你可以讲说，如果你持戒清净呢，你就不会走向那个不归路，就是下三恶道这种这样的境界，就是恶鬼道、地狱道或者畜生道。所以呢，在还没有发生这些这样子的痛苦之前，如果从心念上做主，好好去修行的话，这样你就明白这个戒是很好，你有明白这个戒的各种教法，然后去修持它，保持清净的心念，这样呢这个修行就变成殊胜。所以应该听从佛陀所讲的教法和他所讲的戒律，这些戒律其实是帮助我们修行，使告我们能够了脱在娑婆世界的苦。很多时候都其他宗教都有那种讲一些法呢，都是要控制那个人这个你不可以做，你做这样东西，但是你不需要问为什么。佛陀的教义并没有这样的，每做一样事情佛陀都有一个理由，好像说做什么你要做十善道你可以达到善果，做什么你要拿皈依，这些全部都是在保护你，保护你的心念。所以一层一层的戒律，如果你修了你觉得好，又继续再修，从简单的八戒、五戒，然后沙弥尼戒、比丘戒或者菩萨戒等等一直修上去呢，到最后呢你就能够清除许多许多的业障，拿到好像佛这样子的功德，能够看到佛各种各样的显现的庄严。我们呢在持戒清净的时候，慢慢也会趋向到得到原本的清净心而得到成佛。所以呢我们从这点就看到佛陀的伟大，佛陀的慈悲，佛陀的智慧，佛陀可以运用很多非常善巧的方法了来度我们。所以戒律他所讲的每一个戒都是苦口婆心，是在保护我们自己的。所以呢我们应该好好的守戒，知道这个戒其实也是保护我们的心念，使它护持我们的心念不再走向错误的道路，而且从错误的道路呢造业，然后到最后就是要面临那些痛苦。
Verse 22. My property, my honor, all can freely go. My body and my livelihood as well. And even other virtues may decline, but never will I let my mind decline.We come. So here now, that's something that is making important for our protection of mind. Mind not engaged in the wrong place. Always establish and stay in the right place. So to do this, he is saying, it's not easy.Is hard, but you have perhaps such a vision. Let's say, even I lost my property, even I lost my home, let me, but I will keep my mind in the right place. Of course, your property will not lose, or home not, and home as well.In case, which is more important. Just only this
this life or to free from suffering is more important. See? So this life will go, no? One day will die. But mind falls life after life. If we in the wrong place of the mind, then, as earlier mentioned, that it will lead us to heaven. How will go? We don't want that. So, for that kind of case, even my property, my wealth, my honor, so sometimes we fight for honor, you know. You see, like president, prime minister, how they are fighting for the honor, you know, or for some kind of organization, the status. How much they're fighting, you know? Make a world get problems. So you see, this is nothing. Just for this life. Only for a short period of time. Like 4 years, 5 years, 10 years, you know? How much you can gain from this? But if you lose the mind, then you are just a bad shit. Because my body and my livelihood as well, and even other virtues may decline like chanting mantras. Sometimes like some practice of generosity. There's the different practices. The virtue is practice. But if the mind is in the wrong place, they will not be good. Because even those, even the other virtues may decline. Never, ever decline the mind. Never, I will let my mind regress.
Farmers.
You see those people. suffering they are going through. Sometimes he sits on a tree and thinks. So, because of this thing, and then he himself is like, no, his life is so comfortable. Because his father provided him everything what he needs. And he has such kind of power that he can rule all the country. Well, but he was not attached to those. Because his vision is such great to everybody looking. So, I am a prince, a son of Suddhodana. And the people in the country who's working in the farm, beggar, we are the same. They want peace and happiness, and I want peace and happiness. What's the difference? He fully wants truth. So, to share this wisdom, to show the example, then in the midst of all this excellent opportunities, we let the kingdom for good. Because of that, now the whole world, the Buddhism is something special religion. We will also believe it as a religion. Message. For centuries and centuries, you see, if he is taking the tone, no? That time, during his lifetime, successful. After that, just history. Nothing, you know? In history, he was a very powerful king. Yes, that much. But now his teaching goes everywhere. So we, as a practitioner, we take the responsibility as this morning mission, we study these teachings, we practice these, and then provide, help others. But this message of Buddha's teachings, not just chanting mantra, not just collecting donations, you know. You see, Buddhism is moving more than that, you know. Such a great profound wisdom here, which really can help the whole world. So if we individually make the effort to do these things, I think it will make a difference. No? We just need some this kind of vision in our mind. On the basis of this kind of wisdom, skill, compassion, courage, and the message can go around.
Oh. 接下来就是《智菩萨行论》这本书里面第22条的寄送，无宁是利尽，身体于生计，意宁是于善，此心绝不退。这边呢，所讲的呢，就是我们应该照顾护持我们本有的清净心，我们应该不要把心呢放逸在世间的一些享受和很多的世间法，怎么样子把那个心呢安静下来，然后有正知正念呢？就是我们应该有一种心念，就是说就算我们失去我们的家的财宝、房屋等等呢，我都不会放弃这个修持这个正知正念，也就是修心的这个方法。 这个只是一个比喻，并不是说我们一定会失去这些东西，这个只是内心上一种很大的愿力，就是说注重这个正知正念在修心里面的重要，也就是我们了解到如果我们死去的话，没有好好的修持的话，就下因为业力随业流转的关系，就下三恶道。这些我们的钱财、我们的名誉，这些呢种种呢，我们都不能带去。很多时候世间的人就是说，我为了我的名声、我的正义、钱财各种呢，我就在世间上呢在争取做，但是这些呢种种我们去注重于他的，为了名闻利养方面呢，到最后呢并不能带给我们任何的好处，只是这一世的一个正向的显现。但是如果深刻的想回来，如果我们失去这个护持这个心念，就是拥有这个菩提心的话呢，情形会更糟糕，就是我们会随业离长，我们世间上所做的负面的那些业力呢，会跟着我们轮回转去下一生，而且要面对那个果报那种痛苦。所以呢，就有这个寄送里面所讲的，就算我的身体都受到伤害，就算我的生机或者我的钱财名誉都渐渐的不见了，或者渐渐退掉了的话，或者我们做的其他一些我们觉得善业呢种种呢，如果没有把那个心放在正知正念的话，这些呢我们发了这个愿呢，这些如果退转的话，我们都不会放弃那个真正佛法里面所讲的修心，也就是菩提心和正知正念。然后这个就是整个寄送里面的重点。所以呢明白这一点之后呢，不就讲的时候，当然这个是不容易做到，但是我们明白它的这样好的一个珍贵的教法的时候，我们就应该拿起勇气和一个虔诚心和一个大毅力来去修持这样子的方法，就是菩提心。然后虽然寄送里面我们讲了说失掉这个钱财各方面呢、世间上的东西呢、我们呢都应该知道，如果那些东西这样子出现的话，我们是准备做，也不会放弃那个菩提心，我们会跟着诸佛以往走过的菩萨道，我们一步一步跟着他去走，走到直至达到成佛为止。仁波切有讲到以前我们的本师释迦牟尼佛，他的父皇那时候荣华富贵权力全部有，那个时候他希望他的孩子，就是当时悉达多太子呢，想他继承他的皇位。然后佛陀呢其实是很有智慧，老早就知道娑婆世界的苦，虽然上我们看到佛陀的故事有讲到他过后出皇宫看到那些老人生老病死这样的苦，不过藏人不记所讲呢，在还没有这样之前呢，其实在他的生活里面他也用他的智慧去观察，他也看到娑婆世界各种现象，种种那些幻象呢，只能够使到那些众生呢趋向于痛苦的那个境界。他可以看到那些人到最后是怎么样子的会痛苦到，所以他很多时候呢在世间上呢，他观察世间的各种东西呢，他都会在树下呢时常去静坐去思考这个问题，就是说本来这个皇子他可以有很多很多的权利，而且他享尽荣华富贵，但是他没有执着于这些东西，他有很大很大的理想，他 他有很大的智慧，他会想到我和一般的平民农夫们都是一样。什么一样呢？大家都是希望得到快乐，不喜欢面对痛苦。他也知道这一点，所以他把他所领悟的这个大智慧呢，传播给众生，希望他们修持能够得到离苦得乐。所以呢，你可以看到，当他时间到的时候呢，他就离开他的皇宫，离家，然后呢，在那个修持闭关的时候呢，就成道，然后把珍贵的教法呢，广播到现在。他所传播那个佛法呢，其实2600年，从他那个时候呢，到现在呢，都已经是利益到许多许多的人，许多许多的众生。反过来讲，仁波切说，如果当时呢，他没有用这种智慧去观察，然后去修行，他只是讲当一个国王的时候，他只能够万古流芳，在那个历史上讲到他曾经在那边做过一个皇，是一个很贤良的皇。不过由于他所讲的佛法呢，能够利益到这样多的众生呢，到今天为止呢，这个教法还是一直传播下来，都没有衰败过，还是在帮助着许多众生，使到他们离苦得乐。然后我们知道，佛法呢，并不是只是说念咒，念很多的咒语，或者呢，就是护持佛法，就是捐很多钱。重点呢，就是你应该要开悟，了悟你本有的般若智慧，才能够帮到其他的众生。所以每一个人都应该在这方面修持，转变自己的心念，成佛，然后去利益众生。有了这边的话，我们就能够很善巧地拥有大悲心，拥有那个真正的勇气去度众生。也因为了解这个空性智慧的话，才有这种力量能够帮到其他人。
And that's verse 23. Here now, Shantikara is making a such strong request. All you who would protect your minds, maintaining your mindfulness and introspection, gird them both at the cost of life and limb. I join my hands beseeching you. As earlier, these different methods how to train the mind step by step. Now to do these practices to train the mind, the most important factor is the mindfulness and introspection is awareness. So that is the key center being of the house or the highway. It's also Lord Jesus who put so much emphasis on this mindfulness. He said, the highway for the enlightenment of the Buddhahood is the mindfulness. When the mindfulness is there, then you have all the practices. And he said, the mindfulness becomes part of your mind, part of your meditation. You know, then all your state of mind, nothing but mindful, full of awareness. In there, you miss nothing. So he said, Buddhahood is the perfection of mindfulness. Likewise, here, Shantikara was saying, I join my hand respectfully
第一，接着下来第23颂呢，就讲到我今贺掌劝注意护心者，正念与正知皆因群守护。这边讲的呢，就是祭天这个祭天菩萨，他双手贺掌呢，勤勉我们，就是说一定要守护我们的这个正知正念，看守着自己的心，不要被那个烦恼，就是贪嗔痴所影响到。想要这样做的话呢，就应该随时随地努力的护持，不忘掉我们的正知正念，然后也要一再观察当下身心这方面的正知正见。所以呢，就是以上所讲的，我们要修持我们的心，照这个智菩萨行路里面一步一步的去走，然后这样子呢，最重要的重点还是要记住，要保持心的正知正念，时常要觉知觉照自己的心念，这个是非常重要的。这个就是一条康庄大道呢，这条道路呢是能够指使你趋向于成佛。所以这个不只是那个Shantideva祭天菩萨讲的，我们这个如公嘎珠的祖师，就是尊者祭天松贡，也是曾经强调这样子。他说以这个康庄大道直到得到那个成就佛果呢，就是要有这个正知正念。 The highway of enlightenment to Buddhahood is mindfulness。 所以如果你有这个正知正念呢，其实你就有全部全部的修法，全部全部的修法都离不开正知正念。所以你有正知正念呢，它就是等于是你心的一部分，真正清净心的一部分，它就是等于你的禅修。所以时时刻刻呢，都要保持正念，都要觉知觉照这个正念，使到那个烦恼心这些杂念呢，不要侵蚀到你的身心。所以呢，最后有讲到呢，就是如果你讲到真正什么叫做成佛呢，真正的成佛呢，就是你在修持这个正知正念的时候，你能够100%圆满它。所以就以这个自诵呢，祭天松那个祭天菩萨就贺掌呢，很恭敬的，就是使我们对我们说很虔诚的贺起掌来讲出这个祭诵，也就是代表说这个祭诵是非常的内容是非常非常的重要。
Mindfulness, you know, practice. But if I stay here, it's also good, kind of related. In the, at the time of Buddha, in the country, or one part, I don't know where, the part, countryside of India,There was a small king. He was not Buddhist, but he married to a Buddhist woman. And then he was preparing a big ceremony. So he was inviting all his...teacher, gurus, you know. And then she also said, I have also my own guru, you know. Then he said, yes, then you bring. No. Then she sent a message to Buddha. So in our kingdom, we are preparing such a huge ceremony. So if possible, the Buddha can come. No. Or please send an appropriate monk who can help us. So Buddha sent one of his monks with 500 monks. So then they participated. Then that day, the king performed a very elaborate ceremony. A lot of festivities, dance, singing, and food. There are so many people, thousands of people there watching. Everyone is enjoying so much. So then at the end of the day, the king came down to respect those teachers. Say, have you enjoyed? Was it good? Are they well prepared? What's your impression? So, no. So all his teachers, they say, oh, they are magnificent, so beautiful. The food was so delicious. And then he came to the Buddhist monk and asked the same questions. The head of the monks said, I really didn't pay attention so much. Please ask those who have. No. And the king was really unhappy about that. Said, why, how you can say these things? Because I have shown you in front of your eyes, you know, all this, you know, I exhibited all this. Then the monk said, yeah, I understand your point. You know, so you don't know what I was in my state, you know. So it's difficult to explain it. But I will request you to do something, you know, so that you can understand. So tomorrow, you just, you know, go on the celebration, dancing, music, all this, you know. And then around that court, you just bring out one of the prisoners, you know, who is subject to persecute, who has who made such a great negative, you know. So then, lead that person, the prisoner, two guides, one in the front, one at the back, and give him in his hand a bowl filled with the liquid up to the rim, and then take him down around that ground, and then tell him, if he drops one from that ball, just at that spot, he will be killed. If he walked without any kind of spilling that drop, he will be freed. So the king said, okay, I'll do that. So next day, he took out the prisoner, and as the monk said, and then that man walked around all the way to the ground. And then the monk asked him, requested the king, please ask him if he enjoyed all these enjoyments that I have exhibited, you know. And the king said, asked the prisoner, did you see all these things that I have performed? And the man said, no,
I haven't heard of anything and have seen nothing, you know, because my mind is totally concentrated with this, because it's life and death, you know. Yeah, if it's one drop, you know, a spilt one drop, you'll be killed, you know. So then the monk said, now you see, my mindfulness, introspections, he explained that way. See, this all are temporary, just a magic show. They come and go. There's nothing to enjoy. No. It's just flesh. Samsara is a state of suffering. No. No matter how much you perform these things, the suffering will not go away. No. So we are looking at the root of this suffering and get rid of this cause of suffering, to free from these delusions. So the monk explained so detail to the king. Then king was so admired, so devoted. That's what Buddha's teaching is about. So the whole that kingdom became a Buddhist. So that's what he is saying. Shantideva, you know, I join my hand with respect. Please maintain the mindfulness and introspection or awareness, so that way we will be better off, free from suffering, you know, achieve enlightenment. That's how to protect bodhicitta. See you.
Next,接下来 Rinpoche 就说有一个故事关于这个怎么样修持正知正念，它的意义、它的好处的，就是。 就在释迦牟尼佛的时代，在印度不是有很多很多的小国，其中有一个小国里面呢，国王并不是一个佛教徒，但是他要娶一个妻子是佛教徒，所以他就准备了一个大宴会，请了很多其他的那些外道的。 老师，然后他的这个太太因为是佛教徒，他也提议说应该去请释迦牟尼佛。当时释迦牟尼佛呢就委派了500多位出家众，他的僧众呢去参加这个宴会。 然后这个宴会是，非常非常的大，可以看到很多跳舞、唱歌、吃喝酒各方面呢，都非常非常的多。每一个人那些人民呢去看到的、去参加的，都觉得很满意，都享受到这个宴会的各种事物。 然后到了那个宴会上的时候呢，那个皇帝就沾沾自喜地走下来，去每一个那些外道的老师问他们：“你们觉得怎么样？这个宴会你们觉得你们高兴吗？吃得够吗？种种。”然后那些外道的老师或者高僧们。 都讲非常非常的好呢，吃得好也享受得好，这个宴会非常非常的殊胜。当他走去问到佛陀的佛弟子的出家众的时候，这500个出家众的 最大那个出家众呢，就说，他并不觉得这个有什么好到哪里去，然后当然那个皇非常不高兴啊，做什么每个人都讲好，只有你们佛教的出家众这么讲呢？然后这个出家众这个长老呢就明白，他说我明白你的意思，但是我也很难一下子用文字解释给你听我本身的见解，不然这样子呢，如果要明白做什么我会这样子讲呢，明白你就明天呢你就继续做这个宴会，继续去庆祝，但是呢你庆祝这个宴会的时候呢，你就把你国家里面抓到的一个死犯犯人呢把他带出来，叫做你两个卫兵呢在他旁边，但是呢这个犯人呢你就叫他拿着一碗的那个里面有一些那个油哦，然后叫他拿着放在头上，然后在这个宴会里面的周围慢慢的走动，然后你要告诉他，如果他在走动的时候呢有一滴油呢从那个他的碗里面掉出来的话，这个皇就会把他杀头，把他杀死。如果呢他能够走完之后呢一滴油都不会卸下来掉在地上的话呢，这样呢皇就会释放他无罪。这样第二天呢真的皇就根据这个出家众的指示呢找到一个囚犯带出来叫他走动，这样啊这个犯人就走了一圈，小心翼翼的不使到那个碗里面的油掉出来。过后呢那个皇就问这个罪人，就是说你在这个宴会上你是不是觉得这个宴会很好，你有享受吗？像那个犯罪的罪人就跟那个讲，皇上，其实你里面那个宴会里面的各种那种庆祝，各种吃得好，跳舞歌唱种种呢，我哪里有时间去看，因为我的心呢就是在注意着那个碗里面的油，因为如果我滴出一滴油的话我就要被你砍头，被你杀死，所以呢我整个身心呢那个注意力都是心念呢都是要维持着这碗油不掉下来，所以没有所谓的我看到很高兴。所以这个接着下去，这个长老，这个佛教的长老就跟那个皇讲，这个就是我们所讲的正知正念了，就是说一切所谓的你大宴会上的一切歌舞唱伎，快快乐饮喝吃得好，这样种种就是一好像一个魔术师里面的魔术罢了，一切都是幻化，没有所谓的真正的永恒的一种快乐存在。其实这些这样的快乐只是短暂的快乐，背后呢还是充满着那个永恒的痛苦。这样不管你怎么样子做那个宴会多么快乐，到最后呢那些人呢还是面对娑婆里面的痛苦。所以我们应该呢要寻找这个痛苦的根源，然后把它连根拔除清除掉，然后清除了这种迷惑呢，这样我们才能够恢复为我们原原本本的清净心，能够自在，能够真正的拥有那个永恒的快乐。皇听了之后呢他就非常赞叹佛所讲的话，过后呢他就把他的国呢里面的人民呢都劝他们全部成为佛教徒。所以也就是以这种这样的心态，我们可以看到祭天菩萨山地地方那贺长呢面对我们这些这样修持的人呢，祈求我们好好的修心，好好的保持正知正念，这样才能够得到离苦得乐。好好的维持着这个正知正念啊 mindfulness 啊，就是用里面正知正念里面的菩提心啊来保护我们直到成佛为止。
Then verse number 24, those disabled by ill health are helpless, powerless to act. So this first is an example. Like somebody is like got a headache, then powerless to drive. So I can't drive because I'm strong headache. Or say, today I can't cook because I have a strong headache. Or today I can't write anything, I got a headache, you know? Like this, we're powerless. When the physical health is not good. So like this, the mind when likewise cramped by ignorance, under the control of the ignorance. Mind is unclear, disturbed by ignorance. And then have no kind of sense of right or wrong. So that time said, it's impotent and cannot do its work. So it's powerless to do things right. Just keep making mistake one after another. And then we just follow after the anger, attachment, so forth. So look at this. So seeing this kind of disadvantage, when the mind is under the control of the ignorance. So since I want to free from suffering, so why I'm making this kind of the cause of suffering? No. Since I want peace and happiness, why I'm destroying the cause of the peace and happiness? So say, look at to yourself, look at the mind. So I must maintain the mindfulness and in introspection, the awareness and wisdom that. So this is how how to remind ourselves this kind of practice.
接下来第二十四颂里面有讲到，就是说，为病所忧者，无力行诸事，如是痴忧心，无力行善业。第一点，他这边讲到的第二十四颂，就是那些人呢，他因为他的身体呢健康出了状况呢，很多时候因为这个病呢，他就觉得很无奈，没有那个力量呢去做日常的工作。同样的也讲到，如果我们的心呢被无明烦恼所占领的话，我们这个心呢就不能够很清澈，而且因为无明妄念的骚扰的话呢，我们不能够用智慧呢去看哪一些东西是应该做对的，哪一些东西是恶的行为我们不应该做的，也就是也变成在那种情况下是很无奈，没有那种力量去对峙取舍对或者错。然后也就是因为这样子无明烦恼的关系呢，自己就追随着那种贪嗔痴的念头，直到我们造业，然后面对那个痛苦。所以我们应该从这点这个二十四个那个寄送里面知道，是看到如果你没有正知正念的话， 它的坏处是在哪里？就是说，当你有无明妄念的时候呢，很多时候呢，你就会到最后呢是要面对痛苦。然后你要问自己的，既然你要离苦，既然你要得到真正的快乐，这样你要问自己，做什么你还是要把那些因可以使到你真正拿到快乐呢，把它摧毁掉呢？也就是说，你不跟随那个教导师种下那个得到快乐的因呢，而去造造业做坏事呢？所以当你反问这句话的时候，你就应该关照你自己的心念，然后时常保持着这个菩提心，时常觉知觉照，时常呢都怀着那个正知正念。有了这种正确的智慧和这种觉照呢，这样你才能够修持得到圆满。所以这个寄送呢，是时常警惕自己应该向这个方面去修行。
Now, verse 25, for those who have no introspection, though they heard the teachings, ponder them or meditate, that lack of that introspection is like a water steeping from a leaking jar, leaking pot. Their learning will not settle in their memories. We read many books. Then we analyze, ponder them, investigate, scrutinize. So I understood. Then after that, we're also interested in meditation. Sometimes we do meditation. Do all these things, necessary things. But when these things are not maintained by mindfulness, introspection, then they are gone when we needed them. When strong anger manifests, for example, then we just follow after the anger. All the Dharma study we have done, understood, even we have some meditations, they all are gone. It's not there. So the key here, Shantideva was putting so much emphasis about the mindfulness and introspection, the awareness, maintain that. So maintain the mind, say, yes, this is what's happening. This I'm supposed to do. This how I supposed to I handle. These different important steps are so important, crucial. So, sometimes we wonder, I study, I practice, and then I do meditation. Dharma is great. But then problem comes, then we forgot all those things. Then after some time, it's too late now. It is due to lack of mindfulness and introspection. See? Make sense? So this is a very important point. He is not sharing us intellectual because he went through meditation, Shantideva, like Milarepa. For many years, he was in meditative state. Even he didn't care anything. You know, when you read his life story, he just eat, sleep, and shit. And then the monk they are talking about, oh, this is a disgrace for the community. No, he's doing nothing. They don't realize how much his mind is, you know, in the state of this kind of introspection and mindfulness. See, he went through this training himself. So through his own experience, he's sharing us. As you see Milarepa's Vajra songs. Milarepa is giving his Vajra songs from his heart to the disciples through his own experience, not just intellectual. Some used to read many books, you know, discuss and investigate all these things. Then intellectually they just throw you, you know, all these things. But here it's not just intellectually, through his enlightened mind sharing us. So these are so precious. Like Lord Jigjo Sungun, when he talked, he said, I taught all those profundities of the teachings, but not through my intellectual, but through my own experience, I'm telling you. So like this, you see.
接着下来就是第25的偈颂，偈颂文里面有讲，就是心无正知者，所具闻思修，犹如漏瓶水，不住正念中。并不是讲说我们学佛法，我们读佛经、读佛书，然后我们思考分析。 然后去研究它，深入的去明白它。过后呢，我们就以那个思维在禅修中，很多时候都是在禅修中来去了解这方面的佛法。当我们做了这方面之后呢，如果我们没有继续以一个正知正念去保持。 这些所学的东西呢，这样子的话，很多时候就流失掉，然后那个法并不是真正能够进入我们的心绪。然后，当如果我们遇到嗔恨心升起的时候，我们很多时候呢，这个曾经听闻的佛法呢，不能够。 用上去来帮助到这我们自己，这个也就是从别人这边知道是，如果你没有时常保温，使那个自己保持在那个正知正见里面呢，只是纸上谈兵是没有用的。所以重点，林伯爵还是强调说要有正知正念 mindfulness， 或者要有正知，然后时常都觉照自己的心念，看自己的心有没有跑歪，被无明烦恼占有了。所以这个是非常非常重要的。很多时候，我们闻思在这方面呢，但是因为它没有进入你的心绪，你没有好好的有正知正念，时常是觉照自己的心念。 当有问题来的时候，我们本身就不能解决，自己面对问题的时候用不上去，这些都是因为没有真正了悟到修心里面，最主要是修心。修心呢，就要注重菩提心和正知正念。如果只是纸上谈兵，在那个佛经里面就是文字波阅，自己看了就以为自己懂了，这样是不够的。并不去给一个 那个 Shantideva 祭天菩萨的本身的故事，就是祭天菩萨他的修持呢，他修了禅修了很多年，如果大家有读过他的故事的话，在表面上在寺院里面你可以看到他只是吃饭睡觉和去厕所里面大便小便，所以在这种表面上呢，那个时候寺院里面很多出家人呢就觉得这个出家人太过懒惰了，什么东西都没有做，其实他们不明白这个大菩萨其实他的心呢时常都在关照他的心念，时常都保持着正直正念，保持着那个菩提心，也就是从他这种这样的修持呢，内照的功夫的修持呢，他能够把他所了解在心系里面所了解的佛法，用他的经验把它带出来给我跟我们大家分享，就是这个非常殊胜的这部《智菩萨行论》。同样的，我们在梅拉拉巴的道歌里面也可以看到，他是所讲的东西呢没有离开过佛法，他所讲的东西是他了悟了那个清净心，他时常从那个修持保持这个正直正见领悟到圣意菩提心之后，从他的经验里面内心的心绪里面流露出来的东西，讲出来的东西呢不是只是说文字博乐，好像一般上那些学者学佛这样子，他是从他的 enlightened mind， 就是他开悟了的圣意菩提心的菩提心里面流露出来分享给大家，所以到现在为止米拉拉巴的道歌还是利益到许多众生。同样的，我们的教主吉殿松公尊者呢，他也讲到，我所讲到的深奥的法呢都是从我的经验我的领悟了悟了那个清净心了，明白了那个正知正见啊，各种保温菩提心得到成就之后，从我内心里面把这个经验呢全部流带出来，所以不是从书本来，是从他本身的修持里面啊带出来给我们分享，那个才是真正的佛法。
Verse 26 follows same. So many are endowed with joyful diligence. They are learned also and imbued with the faith. But through the fault of lacking in introspection, they will not escape the stain of sin and downfalls. There are some Dharma practitioners, very diligent, and they like Dharma so much, they appreciate, they have very strong faith, devotion to Buddha, Dharma. But then, say, lack of the introspection, then sometimes they fall into part. So some like say monks and nuns, they disrobe, you see, and due to lack of the mindfulness, introspection, and the negative thoughts enters into the mind stream, and they take away by that attention, and then to lost opportunity. There are a lot of, we have that stories, in our Dharma centers, and in the monks, nuns community. One time said they are so diligent and so interested in Dharma to study, practice. Then after some time, they lost interest. It's because lack of the mindfulness, introspection. So their mind stream is taken away by these negative thoughts. So that kind of, say, the inner demon into the, our mind stream, and that it takes away. So not to happen that, to continue this kind of special journey to free from samsara, to achieve enlightenment, always be mindful of the impermanence of all phenomena. Always be mindful of the suffering of samsara. There's no alternative. See these things. And vigilant, I'm telling you, the awareness. Sometimes you feel, why should I practice Dharma? Is everything okay, you know? That's, you know. But then if you look at this with the mindfulness, vigilance, say, no, this is just very temporary. See these things carefully, and protect your mind, protect the bodhicitta. When you are happy, appreciate, rejoice, my life is good, I'm so fortunate, I can practice Dharma. And I dedicate this for all sentient beings, may they be happy, good life. When they're suffering, then I can say, this suffering is reminding myself where I am in samsara. Because this, I must study, practice Dharma. I should free from this kind of suffering. May every sentient beings may free from this kind of suffering. They achieve enlightenment. So said for both. When your life is good, when your life is difficult, both cases, we utilize this mindfulness, introspection, and carry on our Dharma practice and to develop the bodhicitta.
Jesus先来句26的偈颂， 众人虽多闻， 俱信勤精进， 然因无正知， 将具伪堕后。 这边呢， 仁普济有讲到， 有很多修行者， 他们都是很聪明的， 起初的时候他们也对三宝很有信心， 恭敬心， 虔诚心， 但是呢， 他们没有注重在那个正知正念的修持， 就是没有时常关照那个心念。 很多时候呢， 这些修行者就是因为不注重这些呢， 那个心力慢慢的衰退的时候呢， 你就看到他们退心， 很多时候他们就还俗。 这时常在现代这个末法时期都出现过。 重点的就是在修持之中呢， 他们不懂得原来这个 mindfulness 就这个正知正见是这么的重要。 也就是因为这样子呢， 很多时候呢， 负面的那些杂念呢， 那些不恰当的念头啊， 跑进他们的心绪里面， 所以他们就失去这个继续在佛法上修持的那个殊胜的因缘。 不就讲很多那个佛教中心啊，在海外， 起初可以看到一些出家众， 他们都是很精进， 在文思修方面下功夫， 但是过了一段时间的时候呢， 这一部分的人呢， 出家众， 他失去信心， 对三宝失去信心。 这个最主要原因， 也是因为他们缺少了这个正知正见。 所以他们的脑袋那个时候那个心呢， 就被这个 世间法的各种不对的的那个文化各种各方面的影响，使到他们那得到了那些负面的情绪，常常在贪嗔痴那边打滚。所以这边有很多时候我们是这样讲，他内在的心魔呢已经控制了他真正的原有的那个心念。所以如果要真正的在这个菩提道上，这样属圣的道路里面一直走下去，直到成佛开悟，得到真正的永恒的快乐的话，一定要记住时常都应该有正知正念。怎么样子的正知正念呢？正知正念知道无常，什么是无常，看到很多东西很了悟那个无常，然后正知正念知道说娑婆世界是苦的。正知正念时常要保持着，就是说时常都要关照，不使自己的精自己的心念啊心绪啊跑到一个副作用上，也时常要觉照自己的心念，使它保持正念。然后看到很多东西呢就是步步为营，照顾着这心念，保护着这个清净心，时常保温，保持着本有这个菩提心。然后有时候不管你遇到快乐，你遇到悲伤，你都应该了解到在各种各样的环境的考验之下，你还是要明白什么是正知正念，然后好好的去修持菩提心。然后当遇到问题，当遇到痛苦的时候，不要退缩，就把这个痛苦当作是警惕自己，就是这个就是娑婆世界，所以是苦，所以我们应该好好的要脱离这个娑婆世界的苦。怎么样子呢？好好的学习佛法，不要气软，不要放弃，然后自己有学到跟其他众生分享，也能够利益到其他众生，以这种这样的念来转过我们时常遇到的困难。所以正知正念人不去讲是非常的重要。
Shall we have a short break?
Yes.
Okay, please first take a deep breath. Exhale. Chanjo Senjo Rinpoche Maje Panamake Juroche Keba Nyamba Meba Yang Kone Kondo Pewara Thank you. That's a complete.